more papers, if there will be papers. Oh, it depends on many things, but generally we consider also publication of selected papers in Studia Lógica, perhaps in the form of special issue, but rather in the form of just papers with note. This paper, first version of this paper, were published, were presented at the conference. Now, all this should be, of course, all the papers will go through the usual process of evaluation by two independent referees, and all these things will be more detailed described in an email. Editors will be about him and me. We discussed a bit about title. There is a problem with it. But I hope we will solve it.
Okay,
that's
okay, thank you. So there will be plenty of space for publication, right? So in brief, we can publish a whole book and a whole volume is still off or part
of it. Let me get some. Springer don't like very long books. I think we will manage to convince them to have 300 pages. But I'm not sure, and more important, this series is run by Heinrich Manzing, and he decides my publication. This is already our proposal, which was in preliminary accepted by the editor.
I think it is very favorable. Okay, so let me then start the final, most expected session of this Translogic Conference. So I'm very glad to welcome here Daniele Mundici, who is a member of CLE since I thought 15 years ago or so, and has visited us many times here. Mostly nobody better than him to tell us something about this nice idea of consistency for me three. Very appropriate.
You know, the last speaker has the pleasant task of thanking the organizers for this conference. So on behalf of all of you, I'd like to thank the organizers for this conference. Center of research in Manager is in the middle, and Manage is on the right-hand side, for those who don't recognize me. Here we have, again, Magidor Malic, three Chilean professors that perhaps some of you remember, few of you anyway, and Newton on the extreme right. A young Newton now is 82 or 83.
Mark is going to be 87.
87, yeah, I couldn't even make that description. And here we have a young Carmine, a very young Carmine, with Luis Paul. That's Carmine.
That's a very good word.
And behind the bottom left, we have Rolando Schwarki with Antonio Mario Secchi, former pro-rector of the university. And on the bottom right, we have staff of the clinic at that time, whose names I have forgotten, but these people were working in 85 of the clinic. Okay? And last but not least, a book originated at clinic after those years. On my first book is in Portuguese, by the way, in Brazilian Portuguese. It's about algebra. No, it's about algebra, the logica de paciente, paciente. Okay? And these are the three of those. So, over the last 40 years, CLE has become an international center for, how do you say, a forum for consistency and inconsistency. It's the center of it, the most influential center. Publications, people, invited people. I'm going to tell you more about inconsistency, but not in logic. I would like to talk to you about inconsistency in probability. I will borrow from one of the greatest Italian mathematicians of the last century, Bruno De Finetti. But you will see, it's so natural that you will ask yourself, where is Definiti's contribution? It is like a comics, what I'm going to say. In fact, it's like I say, secondary school students, so I hope not to offend you if I'm too elementary. No technicalities, despite I'm a mathematician. I try to be extremely naive, because the ideas require innocence and open-minded and naiveness. This talk should have been before the talk of Marcel Finger, because perhaps some of you did not follow completely these measures of consistency, probability, probabilistic logic, and so on. This talk introduces that idea at the most elementary level. And introduces also, well, introduces ideas that are developed currently by Julian Meno and Walter, my chairman, on a journal named Entropia, recently appeared. So, this is an introduction to what these three people in Brazil are doing on inconsistency and consistency in probability theory. Sometimes it was asked, yes, I do, yesterday, second floor, what if the rain forecast is 60% and the non-rain forecast is 60%? This was a very interesting question for my talk, in fact. We will have an answer. But for a moment, let's have an opposite situation where the bookie, this fat man, in fact, a professional, gives 0.45 to head rain and 0.45 to not rain tail. There's something odd here. But what? Why is it inconsistent? Let's go. Here is also a fox who tries to defeat the bookie. It's very difficult to defeat the bookies. He they were not law limiting their behavior, all the money of the world would not go to our politicians or to our government, I mean. But it will go to all kids, because they're only, it's one way. So Fox is the better, the one way, just tries to be clever against this opting bets. 0.45 for head, 0.45 for tail. And by the behavior of Foxy, people understand which is inconsistency of that assignment of probability values, but I will not mention probability because probability has to be defined yet. What is wrong? What is inconsistent? What is incoherent? That's definitive terminology about this. So, okay, sells this bet. He says, if you want to bet or have a tail or on both, as now Americans are doing, betting on both presidents, you see, you don't bet for one, you bet for both, you just in case. So he says, oh, I assign 0.45 to head and 0.45 to tail. B of the event E, B of head for B of tail, is what? It's not a probability. It's a much more serious thing. It is a sort of discount. How much you have to pay if you wish to win 1 euro if head comes, respectively, if tail comes. And so, B of an event E is not a probability. It is a number between 0 and 1 telling you the reduced price you have to pay now in the hope of winning tomorrow 1 reale, or 1 million. It's a rate of what you pay now under uncertainty to hope to win the full stake, 1 euro, 1 million, doesn't matter, it's proportional, if the event you're betting on happens. So this is a very concrete definition. This book, a book is a set of odding bets on certain events, okay? This isn't a book. This book is inconsistent. Why? Because it will lead the bookie to bankruptcy. Why? Well, again, I'm betting on Clinton and I'm betting on Trump. Foxy puts 1 million on head and 1 million on tail. Okay, tells me, hey, give me 0.45, 1 million, what you want to win, plus 0.45, tail. Because this is your bet. If you wanted to win 1 euro, you should give me 0.45 cents. 45 cents. If you want to win 1 million, you win 0.45 times 1 million. That makes 0.9 million reais. And Foxy, of course, that whatever happens, either head or tail, tomorrow will come out. I will win 1 million by stake, 1 million. I have spent today 0.9 million. I will win 1 full million. That's what leads bookie to bankruptcy. This is inconsistency or incoherence in probability theory. We haven't finished. Okay. This book is inconsistent because a careful choice of stakes on both events by the bettor leads the bookie to bankruptcy. Because in principle, you bet 1 billion. Then bookie becomes, as you say, there's inflation. Okay? He puts higher on events, higher probability. He puts 0.55 for head and 0.55 to fix ideas for tail. And here is the point which, if you understand, anyone understands what is probability, you will be able now to explain the additivity law for incongruent events And there wasn't a better thing to go for independent facilitation. We have at the beginning. I'm not technical. Now, look what Foxy says. You're inconsistent. Oh, he says, why? Well, because your rates, 0.55 and 0.55, are incoherent in the following sense. Oh, they are the best possible sense, won't you? No. Suppose I become the bookie. I sell you this bet. In fact, I intend to put a stake of minus 1 million. Bookie has not studied mathematics, but it's a stake of minus 1 million. Oh, it's very simple. You give me 1 million now on both events, and I will pay you 0.55 for what comes out. You see, the exchange of the roles of bookie, better. This doesn't happen in real life. All the money goes in one direction, but definitely, and it's a beautiful idea, to define inconsistency as the ability of better to choose negative stakes, which means today you bookie pay to me, but tomorrow I will be the bookie for you, as you would be me with this rate, which I like very much if I can sell it. Perhaps sometimes few of you have argued with some merchant or some shopkeeper, but at this price I would like to sell you oil, or I would like to sell you books, or I would like to sell you some. This is the situation. You don't accept to reverse, to swap our roles. That's your inconsistency. Okay, this is the definition of inconsistency in probability theory. Let's make it absolutely precise. I'm following the 1932 Fundamenta Mathematica, when that Polish journal, Jacek, accepted papers in Italian. He wrote in Italian on Fundamenta Mathematica. My papers in Fundamenta Mathematica are in English. I don't know why. So, as I said, real life bookies do not accept swapping a role with better. So they live inconsistently in the set. And then the study of this should be very important because there is logic underlying this. They put this 0.55 and we will see it concretely. I will show you some, I took them from the internet. You can take them from a Poisson bubble. You see there is a trap here and the better, it's not a false now. Tries the luck. By this, all the money goes in the lift to the bookie. Therefore, despite the consistency, the gunslinger, the duck, decides to bet. This I took from the net. There are, well, some of them are important soccer teams. For instance, CSKA Moscow. It's like Fiorentina, more or less. And others are almost unknown, just because I didn't want to be sued by soccer teams. But these are real-life oddities. If you want to bet that CSKA Moscow wins over Rostov, it already happened, but suppose it happens tomorrow. And you want to win 1 million, you must pay 0.71 times 1 million. So you pay a reduced price, which is quite high because the bookie thinks that Moscow will win. To win 1 million would be good, but it would happen that they draw or that Rostov win. And similar for the other. Observe the sum of these three mutually incompatible events is not good. For instance, FC Tokyo against Urawa Reds has odd bets of 0.4 plus 0.29, which makes 0.69, plus 0.4, which makes 1.09. This makes the bookie a happy man or woman. See? The same happens. imagine is what makes that rich. That's pancreas. They were on infinitesimals, but multiplied by billions, they become money. And it goes. So the conscientious scruples, what he says, like Pilatus, what is veritas? What is veritas? And the book says, what is consistency? How should I behave to be honest? Well, this is mathematics, of course, so that I'm teaching you probability, so I cannot actually depend on what the bookie believes or not, or Pilatus believes. I'm trying to make the mathematics of probability follow the derivative. What is consistency? Now we go back and define mathematics. Again, how much interplayer has been in this conference between logical consistency and probabilistic consistency, deontic consistency, social consistency, and so on. If you remember the consistency problem, for instance, for Payan or arithmetic, is this. Will the rule of deductions, which are time-honored, they started with Babylonians probably 300, 3,000 years ago, will this rule, starting from the axioms, lead to prove that 0 equals 1 is what's called the loss of 0 equals 1. This is an open problem until now. The consistency problem for probability is similar. Will the rule of the game, bookie better, lead to bankruptcy? Okay. So, bankruptcy is contradiction. 0 equals 1, a contradictory state. The rules of deduction are now rules of the game, which I have hinted at and I want to exactly define now. So I'm repeating the same. Yes, of course. Yes. The rules of time honoring betting game, not by bookmakers, by mathematicians. So the rules of the game. We must define events because I'm a mathematician. I don't like to speak of events without telling you what they are. And now, when you say whatever happens, I must define in any possible word. I must define possible word. Oh God, what will happen? You will see. Possible word for monophysm, event, measurable, whatever, algebra. Let's go slow. Event is the counterpart of sentence in logic. Possible verb is the counterpart of valuation in logic. True valuation. So you see, parallel is extreme something. In fact, yeah, we are generalizing logic. Phenomenology, to know the definition, get the definition of event, is something phenomenal. What events should do for mankind, okay? And then you say, are you an event? You must do this. Look, an event can either occur or not occur. Yes, no, would it? Events are closed under negation. Once you have in your mind an event, you immediately have a non-event, a non-event. The non-occurrence of event. Events are closed under conjunction. For any two events, there is their conjunction, meaning that both happen. But this means that events are elements of the algebra. Especially if you try to write them down, you are writing formulas in the position of classical graphics. Anyway, definition. A set of events on which you bet is a set of elements in a fixed wooden algebra. Bookmakers, wooden algebra. Depending on the bookmaker. Anyway, we have a wooden algebra. Wooden algebras, as you know, occur in the standard probability theory, which is due to Kolmogorov. It is a simple wooden algebra closed under count of additivity. I'm very eternal with this because I wanted the probability in the full sense. I'm not doing finite probability. I'm not doing subjective probability. I'm doing probability, showing that definitely equal follow-up. But the same model understands that having to do this sample points or elementary events is a problem, is a psychological problem. And this says the real thing in probability is the family of events, which only, so to say, as a psychological problem, are thought of as sets of elementary events. In this picture, we have the full sample space, the totality of possible worlds. One event, blue, and one point. The event is the set of all sample points, the set of all possible worlds where the event occurs. This is called the world. And Giancarlo Rota, who was a great probabilist, criticizes this, saying, well, thinking of events as sets of points is a psychological problem. This is his, how to say, legacy. It's one of the last papers he wrote. The Fubini Lectures, he was called in Turin, a few months before dying, and he said something about probability. It's really substantial. He said, this is a psychological problem because the correct way of speaking probability doesn't mention these points. He mentions event. But this point does not exist. They are impolite probability. To think probabilistically is to think in terms of the algebra. Okay. So then we have already three liberations helping us, divinity, Rota, and the law. Let's go on. To go back to the elementary school, if you wish, of it's so naive theory of that game that defines probability. Divinity books are in fact assignments of numbers in the unit equal, real numbers. The book, not the stakes, have four. A book is an assignment by the bookmaker of numbers in the unit equal for each event, as we have seen for both soccer matches, morale, dogs, and so on. Kolmogorov equips the Boolean algebra with the a probability function. Definitely does not do that. Definitely derives probability from logic, despite the hated logic and hated Boolean algebra, but we can read all force and contrary out there. Reinterpreting of late. So we must define in all possible words whatever happens. Phenomenology of possible word. What possible words are to do for mankind? Possible word is where event occurs or doesn't occur. A possible word assigns zero, not occur. One occurs to each event. So already a possible word maps events into zero or one. People have studied. And others may think of, well, the possible words if 1 minus p of x is the event as per, it respects negation. Well, and gives the conjunction of the true values to the conjunction of event. The conjunction of true values, what is it? It's the product. This operation is the product. 1 and 1 equals 1. 1 and anything else equals 0. This is just a homomorphism of the number of events into the 2 element set, 0, 1. Possible words, given the Boolean algebra, is the set of maximal ideals, the set of homomorphism of the algebra into 0, 1.
Are you supposing that all elements are independent of each other?
No, I'm not supposing anything. I have a Boolean algebra. management. Since the truth values are only zero or one, of course it will work the whole way theorem. If it goes work, the conjunction must be the end, which is 1 1 1 0, and this way. Very important, if you interrupt me, because I'm defining probability and consistency for nothing. Okay? So events are elements of a polynatra. Possible words are the homomorphisms of this polynatra into the two element set theorem. What else? Having defined phenomenologies of event and possible verb, we are ready to define everything. And here is the finish. You don't assign probability to events because you repeat them uncommitted frequencies. Never! Probability of rain tomorrow is not given by a frequency, it's given by other things. But anyway, frequentists. Definition don't hold for group makers. They cannot simulate the Urala Tokyo soccer match fish. Probability are not assigned by a repeated experiment. We know it. What's the probability that the Brooklyn Bridge are well? You can't repeat. Probability are not linear frequencies. In fact, probabilities are odd in bands. Yes. So where do the axioms come from? I want to show you that the additivity axioms of probability, I will define probability, it's all in vector. I will show that the additivity axiom comes from that, and also the multiplicativity for independent events, which is a very curious thing in probability theory, comes from the basic principles. This is affinity and A. Okay, now mathematics. Game theory sometimes doesn't look like mathematics, but in this case it's pure mathematics. One and algebra, they are homomorphisms, and the numbers. Two players. The better, the bookie, and the better. Who is the better? Par excellence, less Pascal, bet against God. So here it bets more humbly against bookie. The conscience of booking. Okay. What converted by chest is that they are the conscience. Okay, so less is the better. Booky published his book. In other words, he has a list of events. Brazil will win over Argentina, events, and for each event, an odd bet, which is 1, real number, meaning how much you have to pay to win 1 euro or 1 grand, okay? Let's decide stakes. For each event, let's say, oh, on this event, I would like to win 1 million. And this is his stakes. See, we call stake the intended, the hoped amount of money the bettor wants to win tomorrow. Okay, anyway, the stake multiplied by the odds bet. So again, the odds bet is a reduced price because you pay it today and the event need not occur. But if it occurs, you get the full stake. Nothing else. The stake can be negative. But it is a definition of probability. Today, Les, having decided how much he wants to win for each event, pays the odds bet multiplied by the stake in the hope of getting the full stake if events occur. Otherwise, he gets nothing. Summing up. Each event you base S of event. Bookie sells odd events, but as in the previous case, one, and this is the crucial step in probability theory, when the only bets are too expensive, Foxy, in this case the letters, protests with God, protests with Ben, booking, and says, your betting odds are too expensive. I'm willing to advance so much money, the discount is not satisfactory, I don't want. And then the booking firm said, what? These are the best possible odds you bet. And I said, no, I propose that I'm selling you these odds you bet. I want to bet minus 1,000 euro, minus 1 million. And booking, what is it? It's a conscientious definitive, okay? Negative state. Very simple. Now you give me 1,000, and if the event happens, I give you 1,000. Now you give me 1,000 times the odds you bet, and I will give you the full 1,000 if that event occurs. Okay? It's the same, except that I wish to be a booking. Okay, this is the mathematical consensus booking which accepts. So, this is the game. With a consensus booking which is so convinced of the fairness of this one bet that it's willing to swap this role with a better, of course. And then I now see that I have been consistent because with this one bet, again, Foxy can bless. Can bankrupt booking. As before, I repeat it because now the game is defined. Let's sum up. Summing up, given booking, the future possible word V, which is a homomorphism of the Boolean algebra, the total balance is this sum. For each event, how much you pay now, minus how much you will win. We are going to money. Better to me. This is a famous definite formula. It's high school. There's nothing more than high school here. I don't know. Another definition. What is a definitely consistent or coherent book? Okay, it's a definition 32 in fundamental mathematics. And now I will not speak of book stake. Body math. I will just do the mathematics. So the things will, as Goethe said, when mathematicians start speaking, they are like French people, nobody understands anymore anything. But I will try to make myself understood. Given a map, a set of elements of the Boolean algebra, a set of events, and a map, the book, from the events to the 0, 1, we are numbers. The book is said to be inconsistent if the better can choose intelligently states, real numbers, positive or negative, such that whatever happens, radiomorphism, bookie loses 1 million, 1 zillion euros. Formally, for each homomorphism, V in Hom A, simple if you look for an analysis. The sum of SBA minus BA is negative, which means putting SI very strong, I win 1 zero euros. It's enough to ask smaller zero. This is the definition of inconsistency. And our theorem, as it happens, after a definition of theorem that states a book is inconsistent if and only if, now we go to probability theory, it can be extended over the Boolean algebra to the measure, to a probability measure. In other words, a probability measure is something that respects the GPT law. This theorem is fundamental because it explains the additivity law of incompatible events in terms of the notion of consistency. You see? Book is consistent. there exists a measure of the algebra, which means just a function that respects incompatible elements, giving the sum of probabilities. Here comes probability. So, finally edited, I will say something after. Not now, because now we've seen one of the best definitions and theorems about probability. Whatever probabilistic corollary, additivity of probability for incompatible events. It comes not from it works well, this is a posteriori, this is begging the question. It comes from something deeper, the additivity law. Negative stakes, parole swapping, this is a crucial step. Well, cookies make money because they don't accept swaps. Again, less shows inconsistency. Must say you can buy your book if I sell it to you. This is inconsistency. Under all type of events, this is not artificial. Despite you have a reversible booking, it's quite natural. A probabilistic argument must be without points. Yes, I promise to give full Kolmogorov probability. This is something new that, unfortunately, I publish it in the Annals of Applied Logic many other times. It has not been taken up by probabilists. They keep thinking that it is finite additive probability now. There is a theorem, which is essentially a recent presentation, that says that finite additive measure on good algebra, and in one of the solves with sigma additive regular or n measures on the stone space of the algebra. In other words, definitely coherent books give exactly Kolmogorov sigma additive probabilities. Let me repeat. This innocent looking book measure on a Boolean algebra, Boolean algebras are due to their stone spaces. And in the stone space, each book has a sigma additive regular probability measure exactly as advocated by Kolmogorov. So we have also introduced the full-fledged Kolmogorov probability theory. So with such basic stuff of inconsistency, what can we do? Well, we have something deeper than the dogmas about probability. We are proving the dogmas as an atmosphere of human. In fact, I intend, in the stress of my talk, without abusing your mind and your tiredness, I try to prove now the multiplicativity law for independent events. But having proved the definitivity, the additivity of incompatibles, I want to prove the multiplicativity of independence. And it's very easy. My paper in synthesis. I'm a philosopher. It took me a lot of time to publish in synthesis because my mathematical style was exactly what they didn't want. It's impossible to understand. They look like Goethe, you know, like a French thing. You must explain 5 pages, but I'm doing now 2. Observe this quotation by a great probability man who said that independence is a tricky notion. The intuitive notion was what moved the ruling and the old people to make those new achievements. But then came the official definition. You know the official definition. Two events, it was heard by Julian yesterday, two events are independent if the probability of the first times the probability of the second is the probability of their conjunction. Gosh, the first question the man on the street should ask me why independence should require probability. The fact that my afternoon tomorrow will be delayed, and the fact that Brazil will win the next World Cup are independent events, but there is no probability assigned to them. They are not.
You're not sure it's possible.
No, come on, like if you say that, if you say that now you're right, that would be the World Cup in 4 years. Come on. These are independent events. Why? Because there's a probability to run. No! Simply because the two things have no logical relation flat soil. What does it mean? It means that when you write a good algebra of matter planes and the algebra of the World Cup of Soccer, the variables are distinct. So by trace interpolation, this is a technicality, I forget about it, there is no logical relation between these events and those events. Independence is a logical notion, not a probabilistic notion. But then the question arises, why for independent events to give this product law of probability? Why probability? And then let's see why. You see, my dad was extremely alert about this sort of preposterous treatment of independence. Why? A logical notion should require a probability. Independence is a logical notion, long before probabilistic notion. Okay. This separation of variables goes back to Tarski, Kelly, and probably to Boolean. Two Boolean algebras are independent. It starts in 1950. Kelly, Horn, Tarski, Boolean. Two Boolean algebras are independent. Oh, it's technical. I'm very sorry, but there is an equivalent definition. You find it proved by, I guess, by Guy Fanon also. When you can write them in the distinct probability of Cray's interpolation. Okay, so two sets of events are genuinely independent if they belong to Boolean algebras, one here, with separate variables. This is what God gives us about independence. No mention of probability, of course. Separation of variables. So, is show which of the events should I give to the conjunction of independent events. And again, you will discover that if you wish to be coherent, you must give product. But then you discover it as a consequence of deeper facts. Let's go on. I start at 4:15. Mr. Chairman, did I start at 4:15? Yes. I take about 7 minutes, okay? Let's go to our favorite soccer. Here are two independent set of events relating the football match Tokyo Urawa with three events. Wins Tokyo, draw, wins Urawa. And three independent events related about the Colombia Mexico match. What should you do? Here is the what the consensus book has done, observe. It has assigned to each event, there are now 9 events for any possible conjunction, it has assigned a product. Observe, the book he was honest, was consistent. 0.4 plus 1 plus 5 is 1, and so on. And then he was also, he applied the product law. Nobody told him to apply the product law. What he did. We will see that if he hadn't applied the product law, he would go backwards. This justifies the product law. That's the theorem in synthesis. So, let's go on now. Again, what I'm doing now, after having discussed the additivity law for incompatibles, I'm now proving the multiplicative law for independents. Okay. Here is a conscientious bookmaker who has applied the product law. Here, suppose two books about events here and about events here are independent in the sense that the events here belong to a Boolean algebra which is independent to the Boolean algebra here in the sense of that definition by Tarski, or in the sense that the variables are disjoint variables. Then, if they are coherent, the product book exists, and that's another theorem, and is coherent. In other words, the product law preserves coherence of coherent books. That's why there is a product law in probability theorem. You see, from algebra and logic, we have derived the product law in terms of the requirement of being coherent. Then someone of you might ask, well, actually, it's another operation different from product that preserves organs. Second, the product of squares. And then another theorem to prove that the product is the opposite. And this justifies what we learned in probability.
That's the second.
So, for equations,
we take also the other sets.
So, only one equation.
No, I don't.
Yeah, I'm finishing. So far, published, if two books are coherent and are independent, then their product book exists and is coherent. So product preserves coherence. Product is good. Question, is the only good? But otherwise, you'd say, well, I will try to do probability theory independently of the product squares, and the momentum of it. And that's the second theorem, which I'm writing. Well, if you have to publish it, proceedings and makes a paper. It's a 5-page paper. Very elementary, even more, much more elementary. But I want to comment on this theory that product preserves coherence. Suppose I were able to prove the converse. No, not the converse, the opposite. By taking product of coherence, both sometimes you may fail to be coherent. Then this would have been a collapse of the infinity theory and on the product of independent events. So, this shows that going deep with logical notion when dealing with independence, you are able to challenge the, how to say, the legacy of chapter or what you received astrophagically, because then people would have to think. If product does not preserve definitive coherence is something fake or what we know about products, not good for the events that would arrive. Luckily, this is a ratification. That's sometimes what mathematicians do. They ratify the obvious. But the ratification was complicated, extremely complicated, for really stone research and vision, unfortunately, not for me for sure. So, this is important to remark. If you go deeper, you may challenge definitions which are taken as successful ones, theoretically, but you must be able to criticize. This is also a lot of criticism. And the second theorem is that only product will do. If you try to define, say, sharp books over another binary operation, you will not preserve coherence in general as product does. And this ratifies the product law for independent events. Well, you prove nothing. Yes, I prove nothing because everybody, millions of people are doing probability theory with his dogmas. I like to confirm them using logic and affinity, which seems to be extremely natural. Okay. Well, if you like any value of logic, luckily you can do the thing also for continuous events, which are those we bet on more frequently than yes, no events. But this is a technicality, if you like. Let me finish with some remarks about past research. We have defined consistency in a super elementary, convincing way, resting on Definetti's idea, which are genuine, ingenuine idea. We have used some technicalities very little and makes the humanity sometimes, and Definetti's theorem, which is the fundamental theorem of logic programming, in which there are many forms of proof, Arcas lemma. Separation of atomic body by the cosmic. Anyway, it's a natural theorem which everyone can prove. If you think historically about the consistency problem of logic or arithmetic, you will see that the consistency problem came out very late in the history of logic. The Greeks didn't have a problem of proving the consistency of the Euclidean axis. They took them as very good, like the axioms of Pascal and Christine, or the axiom of chemistry, probably, if there are any axioms. Are there axioms in Pascal and Christine? The Greek understood Euclidean geometry as we understand now Pascal and Christine, or perhaps as chemists understand chemistry. It was, of course, the success of this method that made the problem of checking consistency and see there are models for certain axes of what a theory came. But last century, 1930-something, and the consistency problem, no Italian logicians even, you know, they are, I have no idea what were those Germans doing about consistency. It was extremely interesting, and that explains why Italian logic at the Piano had to wait 40 years to be born. So the consistency problem is a sophisticated problem that comes at the end of thousand years of analysis of the roots of A. And here, too, the consistency probability is just in this naive state, as you say, kindergarten state. It needs a lot of analysis, a lot of study of the problem of consistency, because bookmakers still profit from inconsistency. We must understand why consistency pays. Of course, the items pay, prime pays. I don't want to abandon that trivialized thing. Anyway, there's a lot to be done about consistency probability, and we did for in our attempt to explain the dogmas from something deeper, out of logical, not logical nature. Thank you.
Compactness.
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 Compactness. land and earth are packed. Certainly. The still space of every Indian is compact. Yes, all this is compact.
Okay, so, well, maybe.
There's an observation if you not a physical system. If you believe that compactness is what explains finite entropy, if you were so, finite entropy would be sort of equivalent to infinity entropy, which is not.
Yeah, that's a good point.
It is not. Finite entropy at your right level responds to signal entropy at the topological level, varying and varying between good and bad. Maximum area of space that is key of your body. So they are the same, but you must go from the algebra, by the finite relativity, to the second possible words, which is a compact, generally disconnected house of space. And even the algebra is the most general compact house of space, thereby recovering full sigma theory by one-man correspondence blind duality. See?
Please, Professor, I have two really pedestrian questions. But I'm still having some doubts, so maybe I have only one leg on this, so I have to jump. The first question is the following, concerning the example of the deans of the match. Well, you have three different values. I would say that each one is an event. Okay? So, but the way you presented it seemed to be all of them considered to be the same event. Or, in this case, we have three events that are connected. This is just a...
No, I think that, for instance, the Moscow cross, there were three incompatible events whose union was the wins Moscow, wins Roscoe, draw. There are three events. And also, when I made the plot, I had nine events.
Okay, but they are connected.
Okay.
Okay, and my second pedestrian, very pedestrian question is, what is the axiomatics of Tuscan cuisine? The axiomatics of it, yes.
For the axiomatics of Turing cuisine, I would refer to friends talk a lot about the axiomatics of chemistry. Yeah, yes, it works.
It was chemistry. Forgive me, I understood that. I understood my idea, but not good. I understood Tuscan.
Tuscan talk. I
watch it.
I should use more.
Thank you.
question seems to be about my capabilities. I would distinguish between given definition of consistency, which I gave, which is a definitive definition, and proving that this theory is consistent, I think, with Ferdinand Franklin, with Joyce, that theory of the first order.
Italo, helped me a lot here. And students Edson, Alfredo,
Laura.
Laura.